Ford engine rebuild again. So rebuild. Let's see what's going on with this engine actually. The crankshaft is bent and I don't know what else. It's gone. You can see that it's out of the circle here. It's much more up. It's pointing like that. Okay, let's start open everything to see how it looks like inside. Alright, cylinder heads out. I have to make it upside down now. There is no detonation, there is no any missing piece from the piston or something. I have to count also the cylinders, but that looks fine. Then I was afraid because I don't know what's going on with the crankshaft, how bad it's bent. I didn't know if the first pistons they touch on the cylinder head. So then you see here on the cylinder head, it looks nice, perfect. The head gasket doesn't have any bent spot or something. You don't see any marks on detonations or something. And the only thing what I saw is that at this point here, right here, it's clean and shiny at this spot. Talking about here. And then if you come on the piston, it's inside, there is one slightly mark over there. It's been cleaned. It's not reflection or there. Wait, one second. I'm talking about here up. This is not a reflection. You can see even when I'm moving the light, it's still there. And there is also another one down here. But again, this is not a reflection because I'm moving the light and staying there. I'm talking about down here and here up. So the fuel mixture looks perfect. I don't see any hot spot or something. The valves are excellent. There is no problem with the lubrication or something. The valve is dry. They're not wet for the valve seals. How do they replace it? The studs are here, lifters here, they are perfect. Push rods, the only thing what I did is just roll it down to see if they're straight and it looks perfect. Rocker arms, perfect. There was not any problem with the engine. I hit it without the belt, I removed the belt from the pro charger and I hear the engine was working excellent. Let's make it upside down to make disaster down the floor here. Open the oil pan, the timing cover front, remove also the oil pressure sensor from here. Strip it off completely to see what's going on. One second to get the camera to see what's the problem. Come here. Just now open the oil pan, alright? Okay, see the crankshaft. Have a look on the crank. It cracked the crankshaft. It broke the crankshaft completely. Take a look. It was running. Vibrations and pressure. And take a look. Had survived the piston. Now need to be checked. Oil pump. You can see some pieces here. I need to check the oil pump because the oil pump has 2,000 miles. If I open it and doesn't have something inside, I'm gonna use it again. What's the problem? Timing chain. I saw pieces here and I see that it has stuck on the timing cover, the timing chain. You see here? See how close it has come? It came out from the bearing,
yes,
the crankshaft here, and then it's stuck front on the timing cover. I hope the connector will be okay. Most probably, maybe we're gonna use two new connectors because there are some pieces here, and if they're scratching, they're gonna increase the clearance between the connectors. The rest looks perfect. The rest looks okay. So you see now why I open everything? Because by just opening only the oil pan and fuck our lives on the engine,
yes,
you know, I can swear on YouTube. You know why? Because I make this one, the policies what it has for the children, that's not it's not good, the video you know, for under 18 years old. So I click on it. I tell them, don't give this, don't show this video to the children. So instead of fucking your life there on the car, you know, trying to remove the oil pan, that's almost impossible, that does have space.
We have no space here.
But even make it on, put on the jack, make it upside down with all this mess here, just to verify what, that has a crack crankshaft or it's bent the crankshaft. With one way or the other way, you have to strip off everything. There should be metallic pieces, even if it was not been cracked. So, let's continue to see how it looks like. We have also another one crankshaft from GTR.
Yeah, GTR 35. Yeah.
We have a crack.
Yes.
That's been split. All right, let's continue. Nufu, come to see me. Why are you staying there? Why are you far away? Come to see. Also, nice explosions. See?
Yes.
Nice crank, eh? You see? All right, let's continue. Shit! Fuck! I'm here, I'm saying, okay, let's continue and open the oil pan. The oil pump. Pooh! Why I'm saying, okay, and I'm coming here, I'm trying to lose the bolts and take a look at the oil pump. Focus, please. Take a look there. Once upon a time, there was an oil pump. I lose this one. I lose these two bolts. And then I say, why in hell it's moving like that? And then I see this. Nice. So we have to, obviously, also the rod here. That's, there is one heat on the rod that's moving the oil pump that's going through the distributor. I'm talking about the rod that's coming, where's the distributor? There, there. That comes inside of this. Obviously that's because all over the place. Okay, we have to put on the list one oil pump at the same time. Continue. Okay, let's have a look how it looks like without the oil pump. That's how it looks like. Go figure out, and then you can see the bearing. See how it ended up the bearing. Yeah, you're gonna tell me what you're expecting. It's all over the place. Then it's stuck. Holy crap! I hope the crankshaft cap. No, we can order it probably. Either there's any problem with the crankshaft cap. Camshaft, fortunately, there's no any problem. Anyhow, okay. Then what we have? Obviously, we have the oil pump. As I said, it's been broken. The timing chain here. It was running on the timing cover, you can see here, and then the rod that's giving movement to the oil pump that goes, this goes like that, okay, but this is turning it. You can see here that it's been hit by the crankshaft there and there. Okay, let's continue now to open the, I have to mark the pistons in which position they are, actually, what to mark, I have to change all the bearings, I'm not going to get the chance. There are so many glowing things inside, take a look, when it's coming the Christmas, I see glowing things everywhere. Why, this is, I don't know, maybe some people they should stop driving their cars, you know, 1 month before Christmas, right? Because it's a Christmas mood now. Okay, so there is all these pieces in the oil pan, obviously, with all this mess. I mean, since it cracked the crankshaft there, just only takes only 2 revolutions to come completely disaster everything. In 2 revolutions, it can destroy everything. Let's see also the cylinders, because I see some pieces over there now. Because I make upside down, all the pieces what you see over here, it fell there on the cylinders. And it's not very safe to move the pistons right now. So most probably what I'm gonna do, before I open the pistons, I'm gonna go to the cleaning room there inside. I'm gonna wash it with petrol, I'm gonna blow it with air. I'm gonna make it upside down and blow the engine upside down with air and petrol. To remove all the oil and at the same time to remove all these things, the glowing stuff, so don't make any problem with the cylinders. I can refresh the cylinders, but if I make one line, no, I don't want to cause any line. Even if there is a line, I don't want to be responsible and make a line. There is some lines over there. There, at that spot over there. All right, let's continue. All right, yeah, I said that I have to go to wash it, but see, how we're gonna pause it for now, because I already see what's the problem. I'm gonna open also the crankshaft cap here to see the engine block. The engine block should be fine. I'm gonna just open the first cap here just to see what's the condition. I'm gonna pause it because I'm busy with some other cases, and then we're gonna continue later on because now it takes. I have to go there, wash it from the oil, and then bring it by again. So that's the first part. If I have a chance to do it today, then we're gonna see the crankshaft on this video. Otherwise, if I don't do it today. Tomorrow? What? I don't know what day it's today. What day is today? Wednesday?
Yeah, Wednesday.
Wednesday, okay. Yeah. All right, yeah, so we have a chance to make it tomorrow. All right, that's it. Thank you very much. If I don't have a time, as I said, tomorrow. Thank you. You're not gonna go anywhere, you know? It's already broken. Look how it looks like. At least there's not too much damage on the engine block. Just gonna clean up over there. The cap, I want to change it. I want to replace it. Because you can see from the temperature, it changed the color there. I have no clue if it's perfect round or whatever. The bearings, obviously. Who cares about the bearings? And this is the other piece of the crankshaft. There you are. Okay, let's bring the welding machine and weld it back again. Okay, but at least looks like the connection would survive. Yeah, I know it's a drop in the ocean, but something is that, right? Have to count it. Yeah. Yeah, I said to start the camera again because I want to open this. This doesn't have any difference. I can open it without moving the pistons or something. I didn't move anything actually. So yeah. Now, as I said before, as I said earlier, let's see how it's gonna be today. And if I have a time, I'm gonna wash it and then I'm gonna continue opening it. I don't think so I'm gonna have any other problems. It's enough big problem this. No need to have more. That's it, thank you.